So what is scrubber? Scrubber is basically a liquid and particle contactor. So if you look outside Mother Nature when it rains, all the pollution we generate and fine droplet that's in the air get washed out by water droplets. So that's a physical contact between particle and water droplet. There are various throat design, as you saw in the previous slide, between four scrubber, and I will explain it as we move on. So these various throat designs' main purpose is to have contact between gas, water droplet, and solid particle. And that is what creating pressure drop in the scrubber. So scrubber basically works on impaction, interception, and diffusion theory. So imagine a piece of pipe. You have an air, water droplet, and solid going through it. A particle are big enough because of its own mass. So say particle, generally speaking, 3 micron and larger, are because of its own mass when flowing in the straight path with water droplet, air, and solid going same direction. The solid particle, because of its own weight, hits the water droplet and gets collected. When particle is between 1 to 3 micron, the particle tries to go around the water droplet, falls within half diameter, hit the water droplet, gets collected. That's called interception. In diffusion, the particle is so fine that it behaves like air molecule. So we all are standing or sitting, and air molecules constantly going around it, but we don't feel it because air molecules are so light, they change their path and goes around. In scrubber, because of the constraint of the throat, when particles are fine, it creates a random zigzag motion, but it does not have more area to go anywhere. And that's how it collides with the water droplet and gets collected. So in general, finer particle, more pressure drop to have impaction, interception, diffusion. Heavier and larger particle, less pressure drop to collect that particle. So particle collection depends on the particle size distribution and particle specific gravity amongst a lot of other items. Pressure drop, liquid rate or liquid to gas ratio, percentage solid in the recycle loop, they are very, very important for efficiency. To obtain impaction, interception, and diffusion, you can create more pressure drop to bring them together, or you can use more liquid rate. Or you can use lower percent solid in recycle loop, means discharge more water. These three parameters you can change. So you can have lower pressure drop, higher liquid rate, lower percentage in the recycle loop. You can have higher pressure drop, lower liquid rate, and different percentage solid in the recycle loop. So these three variables can be adjusted to reach the efficiency goal we're trying to go to. When we talk about percentage solid in recycle loop, now there are two types of solid, dissolved solid and undissolved solid. When particulates are soluble in the water, we can design for higher percentage in the recycle loop. So many different things we can do with scrubber design as long as we know the design data and as long as we know the goal, what we're trying to go for. Cyclone scrubber pulse jet filter. The difference for the cyclone and scrubber part is the design data. Your design data has to be very, very precise. And many times when I go out and meet with customer and engineering group, I talk to them that spending some money to gather the data will save you a lot of money throughout the life of that equipment. Because if your data is not correct, either you're going to use more horsepower, more liquid, or combination of both. So design data is a key part in the scrubber